stormwater presentation by the Director of Public Utilities, Robert Spadell.
President, Madam Vice President, thank you for the opportunity to co-present to you and your colleagues on stormwater utility. Hopefully we get invited back to talk about wastewater and natural gas and water and electric. There's a lot of good things going on in those utilities also. So today we want to not plow the old ground. In December we were at land use and we talked about agreement structure at length. In January we were in finance committee and we talked at length about the stormwater billing and collection. So today we wanted to bring you an update on operations of the stormwater utility. Next month we'll be bringing you the mayor's budget with the stormwater utility as well as the other four utilities, and we'll be back talking with you again about the cost of the utility. We have all the leaders of DPU here today will be able to answer any question you may have of us, and we're very much forward to presenting to you. I am going to ask Michele Virts, who is our face with the stormwater utility, to come up and make the presentation.
Good afternoon, I'm Michele Virts with Public Utilities. I'm just going to give you a brief overview on where we are in the utility today. Just some background, you know, we are an old urban city, and so because of that, we have many streams that are impaired and that do not meet the water quality standards for a usable stream. And part of that is because stormwater runoff is one of the major sources of pollution to our streams and to our river. At the same time, EPA, the federal and state agencies actually, have been looking at the Chesapeake Bay and want to improve the quality of the entire Chesapeake Bay, which we are a part of. And the current estimates for improving the water quality are up to about $30 billion for all the needs for the entire Bay watershed. So we know we have these water quality problems and these flooding problems, and the goals of our stormwater utility are to protect our public health, to protect our properties, to improve and protect our public safety and mobility, and to improve our economic opportunities in the city. And just a reminder of how our utility is calculated. Again, this is a fee for each property within the city, and it's billed based on the amount of impervious surface or hard surface on your property. So in this example, on a non-residential parcel, we look at the building area, parking area, and any other hard surface like a walkway or a patio. We summarize that and we divide it by the average residential square footage, which is 1,425 square feet. So in this example, this parcel would be billed 10 times our ERV, which is $45. Again, just some more history. We began looking at this stormwater program in 2003 when we had our first stormwater permit issued to us, and the stormwater utility was adopted in 2009, and since then we've offered credits to both the residential and the non-residential customers, and we have over 70,000 customers. Again, our revenue is derived from all property owners, so that is tax exempt and taxable parcels. Our program does cover all of our permit requirements. Again, that's a state permit that we are issued to by the Department of Conservation and Recreation. It covers any routine maintenance that we do on our pipes, our ditches, our inlets. It covers our mosquito program for the city, and also drainage complaints. When the utility started in 2009, we had over 1,200 drainage requests that were in backlog that just hadn't been addressed. And we reduced that down to just over 200 in the past few months. We're also working on capital improvement projects with the stormwater utility, and these will address our larger flooding concerns. It will also help us address our water quality needs so that we can comply with state and federal governments. And to do that, we're looking at developing watershed master plans. And what I mean by a watershed is an area that's draining to a specific stream. We'll look at that area and identify the needs treat the stormwater, and it also is a learning opportunity for the students. And finally, we do have a credit program in place for all of our property owners. For the non-residential customers, they can get a maximum of a 50% credit. And the credit is based on what they do on their site to improve stormwater runoff. And our residential customers also get a credit up to 50%, and that would be for any type of measure like a rain barrel or a rain garden, or disconnecting their roof drains to our storm sewer system. That was a brief overview. Do you have any questions?
I know that we're probably going to have a lot of questions. Yes, my council colleagues are going to ask at least two. One, there's been a lot of discussion about problems with collecting this utility fee. And there have been some comments made by the Department of Public Utilities and Finance about how they're working to resolve that issue to ensure collection occurs. Can we get an update on how that collection, how the providers are going to do the collections better in the future?
Yes, for the current billing period, as you remember when we presented finance, anybody who had a past due amount that showed on their current bill, and when we notified them of their past due amount, we also notified them that they would receive three notices between now and July 1st that allows them to bring their past due up to date. We would waive late fees, we would waive late charges. And as of July 1st, they would
be back. I'm sorry, can somebody check on Donnie back there, please? Donnie, you okay, man?
No.
Okay. I'm sorry, Mr. Stadell, would you go on?
So as of July 1st, they'll bring themselves up to current on their bill and not pay any extra fees, and we would happily waive those. If they couldn't make those payments, we are working very aggressively with everybody who needs a payment plan, and we are working with them hard to be sure that set up a payment plan with them that works for them. But these are mostly the large folks that have large impervious areas that have just gotten behind other payments. So we're working very aggressively with them to be able to find something that works for them. And we will continue to work with them. What we always ask people is if they are behind another bill and they just don't know where to go, please call us. Don't just not call us, because if you don't call us, that's the worst thing you can possibly do. We work with folks. Mr. McLean and his team will just make sure that we work with as best as possible. As of July 1st, we will start to bill monthly on the utility bill. So instead of receiving one annual bill, they'll be chopped up into smaller bites, and a lot of people have said that's going to help them with their ability to pay. All those are taking place. Since we started this process, we've seen about $1 million extra dollars of revenue come in from past due accounts. So people are starting to read their bill inserts and understand that it's to catch their past due money.
Thank you. I bet the other question a lot of us are thinking is, it's been said to almost all of us by our constituents, Richmond is the only one in this region that has a stormwater utility. How are the other ones getting away without having to?
Well, it's true in our metro area, the planning district area, we are the only ones with the utility. There's another 15 utilities in Commonwealth of Virginia, but we are the only one in the area. Michele works very closely with her colleagues, and I don't want to speak for them, but they all recover their costs through their real estate taxes. They take a certain portion of their general fund and they invest that into the stormwater program. In December, the Chesapeake County indicated their stormwater capital program is over $200 million. And they weren't quite really sure whether they're going to recover that money, but they're talking about it. Do you want to talk any more about what you're talking about?
Perhaps a meals tax.
All of us as localities are trying to identify how we're going to come up with these bay mandates. And so several localities are looking at stormwater utilities or other dedicated funding sources.
And Ms. Virts, is that why on slide 7, stormwater utility revenue, you're indicating approximately $2 million of additional revenue is 1 cent tax increase. I'm assuming that's the real estate tax that you were discussing now?
Correct.
And so if we were to do this, like just for those of our real estate taxes, we'd have to bump up the real estate tax 4 cents?
Correct.
Approximately.
Correct.
Thank you. Are there other questions from council members? Ms. Trim.
Mr. President, with
their taxes and Chesapeake County is a whole lot cheaper than our taxes.
That is very true. There's also almost two times the number of people paying taxes.
I need to say this. I think that we were not told the truth a year ago or 2 years ago when we started the stormwater. We were told that everybody, all the surrounding counties would be paying it. And here it is today, and they're still not paying it. And now we talk about, you know, they do not pay this. Their utility bills were cheaper than ours every month. And I don't understand what you just said about every month that they will start getting another bill. Is that what the stormwater?
Right, the stormwater charges for an annual bill being divided up into 12 equal payments.
Like it's not, like, it can be either $25, $45, or $70, right?
Divided by 12 would be the number of payments.
So every month we'll send them out another bill, tell them you owe a dollar or $1.50 or whatever?
It'll be on the same utility bill that you pay for your gas, water, wastewater, and trash.
So you're going to attach this to the utility bill?
It'll be short on the utility bills.
I don't like that at all. Because everybody's going to say that the utility bill went up. And not even pay attention to that. They're going to be screaming, hollering at us that the utilities have went out, you know, went up again. And not only that, you know, we send them out usually in December, and they have until, I mean, that's Christmas and everything else. They had to pay the stormwater, then they had to pay the real estate taxes. You know, all that at one time, they need these, the people in the city of Richmond. And the churches, too. Don't, let's not forget about them and the nonprofits that have to pay this.
And again, we have told them we're reaching out to the community. We have said to anyone who would like us to come and explain this to their local groups. We believe this is what most people said was the way they would like to see their stormwater bill. We'll explain it to them, make them understand exactly how it's going to look on the bill and exactly what the amount is. We can talk with people about their past due at that time, and we're here to be able to explain to the citizens as best as possible.
Well, I know when they, people in the 8th district, I'm not speaking for the rest of the city, I guess they got more money than what we have, but they are furious. They don't want it. They want it gone. Especially when I kept telling them over a year ago that surrounding counties were going to be paying this too because it was mandated. They have not been paying it. And when you talk to some of them in Chesapeake, they say no.
Well, they do have the same costs we do. In Chesapeake, they've been paying their public works department, not in their public utilities department, in Hanover. And right when they pay it in their public works department, not in their public utilities.
And then also, we were told that they were not to be charged, you know, late charges and stuff like that. I know we had that discussion. We tried to pull those dates. I don't know where they're at. But I know that I asked that question. Are we going to have to charge them late charges? And we were told no.
Well, again, from 2009 up to July 1st of this year, we will waive all those late charges if people bring their charges current. I think that's consistent with what we've been telling you. We have not started to charge late fees yet. It will only be after July 1st of this year for any amount of the balance that's not current.
Well, you want to know something? They're going to have to pay it now because you want to attach it to the utility bill, which that's not right. Do we have any say-so over that? I do not think we need to do that. We don't need to do it. People are having a hard time now paying the utility bill. Gas and water.
Well, again, we work with anybody who has a problem. They call our customer service department. We work with them left and right as much as we possibly can to help them with what they can afford.
Thank you, Mr. Steinbaum. Are there other questions? Mr. Angelowski.
The stormwater utility fees that we collect, it does go towards the maintenance of our storm drains and clearing them out every time those backups continue. We get notice that we've got to do something because the streets are flooded. Is this correct?
Correct. Because the fees that are collected by stormwater utility can only be spent in the stormwater utility. Each utility must keep its dollars within where it collected the funds from. We use those dollars for capital improvements and for maintenance and for emergency repairs. So when you call and you say you've got a backup drain, the stormwater utility personnel will get paid by the fees of the ones that go out.
Thank you. Mr. President, may I ask another question?
I wish you would.
Thank you. We've seen some interagency partnerships recently, particularly around the Capitol, 14th Street. I think that's fantastic. I think we've seen nonprofits who've got passion for dealing with environmental cleanup helping to contribute to do this effort, which I think is fantastic. I would commend you all for finding a way to work with these non-governmental agencies. I think that's very important, and we encourage you to continue to do that.
We are very fortunate. The governor in his budget has put in $35 million statewide to assist localities with capital improvement projects, specifically for stormwater. We hope that survives the general assembly process and be another source of funding that we could look to for assistance in our CSU project. We have been very fortunate, though. Michele worked very, very hard to partner with a lot of people to be able to bring us grant dollars and other forms of contribution and aid to be able to do this.
Thank you very much.
Dr. Newville, and then Mr.
Aye. Just really quick, you referenced the General Assembly and the dollars that have been earmarked, and we all hope they survive. If we receive those dollars and whatever that amount, would that be an opportunity to reduce the stormwater fee at all? Or is it just simply, yeah?
It would be an offset. We don't budget to have grant dollars provided to us, so what we do is we get those grant dollars and offset them what we plan to do for CIP. Now, in that case, it could either mean we can do another CIP project that may also be up very high on the priority list. We have more priorities that we'll never be able to fund in the next few years. So we would use those dollars either go to the next project down, or if that project is still too big, then those dollars we have to carry over to the next year. The stormwater CIP projects are not small. They're very large. Fix something at one point, you have to go all the way upstream to where the problem starts and work your way all the way down. So we'd be trying to manage the money as best we possibly can. We would use it either as an offset or we would want to move it into the current fiscal year.
Mr. Chairman, as you asked the question, I need to let you know, and this spoke earlier, they don't have, just those have twice the population, they have 1.5
If the ones have already paid their stormwater, like say, 1st of January, you're not going to be adding that on to the utility bill. You have a record of everybody that's paid in full, right?
Yes, of course. The fiscal year will end on June 30th, so everybody who's up to the end of the fiscal year.
June the
30th is the end of the fiscal.
Okay, but if they do not want you to put this on the utility bill, would they contact you and tell you do not do this?
The only way we're going to bill in the future will be on the utility, but we're no longer going to be doing the annual one-time fee. We're going to discontinue that program and go to billing all the fees on the utility bill.
Right, another question. If people would take that, they take the stormwater and they claim it on their tax bill, how they will now do this when it's added into their utility bill? Because I know a lot of landlords take this utility bill or the stormwater bill and take it off on their taxes every year.
They can continue to do that because, again, we're going to bill on a fiscal year basis, or they can, for the tax year, they can still add up everything they paid for stormwater should they choose to put it in their taxes.
Because we need to talk about this. I'll tell you right now, when this gets in the paper, whatever, the Free Press, the Times Dispatch, whatever paper, people are going to be furious about this. And we don't have to say so to say, no, we do not want this added to their bills unless they want it. And the citizens of Richmond, if they want it, that's fine. The ones that don't want it, they should be given a bill for it every year, not put into a utility bill, like when your gas and water is like $300 a month like mine is.
Well, Mr. Spinell, I think you did say that if you receive your bill and you want to pay it all at once, you certainly are still allowed to.
You can certainly pay ahead in our system, and we will credit you that for the entire fiscal year.
So they still can pay. They don't have a separate bill, and I think that's your point, right? That you want a separate bill, separate mailing, away from the utility mail.
Yes.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Mr. President.
Mr. Blount.
If the bill is added to utility bill, how will the credits for rail girls and such be accounted for? You send a check back, or will they just cut the amount in half?
We cut the amount in half. When somebody applies for it, we automatically put it into their amount due for that property, and it maintains the property through a system of renewal and saving.
Thank you. All right. Thank you guys so much for your presentation. We appreciate it. Dr. Beal was your answer.